Hello students, hope you all are safe and healthy at your home. Today also we will continue with the lesson Chemical Reactions and Equations. We know that chemical reaction is a chemical change and we can classify chemical reactions in different types, and these types are combination reactions, decomposition reaction, displacement reactions, double displacement reactions and redox reactions. So the first is combination reaction. The reaction during which two or more reactants combine to make one product. These are the examples you can observe. In all three examples, two are the reactants and they are combining to make a single product. So these kind of reactions are called combination reactions. C+O2 gives us CO2, CaO plus water gives us CaOH whole twice, and Na+Cl2 gives us NaCl. In the first equation, carbon is reacting with oxygen. This equation is representing burning of a fuel. All fuels contain carbon particles, and those carbon particles react with atmospheric oxygen to convert into carbon dioxide. Calcium oxide plus water gives us calcium hydroxide. Sodium plus chlorine react with each other to give us sodium chloride. Sodium chloride is also called table salt, which we use at our home. There is another kind of change, that is endothermic and exothermic. Endothermic are the changes during which heat energy is consumed, and exothermic is just opposite to endothermic, during which heat energy is evolved. Example of endothermic changes are dissolution of sodium chloride in water and photosynthesis. And examples for exothermic changes may be respiration, dissolution of NaOH or acid in water. Okay, these are the examples. All combination reactions are exothermic in nature, means during all combination reactions, heat energy released. Here is a use of one of combination reaction in our daily life, that is in whitewash. Children, do you know there are involvement of chemical reactions in whitewash? This is the picture of quicklime, and the chemical name of this substance is calcium oxide, which is also called chuna in Hindi. It exists in the form of lumps. You can observe here in the picture. We have to add this quicklime in water to make a liquid mixture. During this kind of mixing, a large amount of heat is evolved, because this process is an example of exothermic process. So if we will touch the container or the mixture, we feel it hot. After some time, when it becomes cool, we can apply it on the walls or roofs. In this slide, the first equation represents the chemical change during the formation of the mixture. When we will add quicklime in water, it will turns to or converted into slaked lime, or we apply this slaked lime on walls, and after 2-3 days calcium hydroxide or slaked lime turns to calcium carbonate by reacting with atmospheric carbon dioxide, which is represented here in the second equation. So on the walls, ultimately at the first we have added calcium oxide in water, it turns to calcium hydroxide. And after 2-3 days, calcium hydroxide will convert into calcium carbonate. So these are the reactions involved during the whitewash. Some other examples of exothermic reactions are respiration, decomposition of vegetable matter into compost, burning of fuel, neutralization reaction, rusting of iron. Neutralization reactions are the reactions in which acid and bases are mixed with each other to make them neutral. This is called neutralization reaction. So during these all processes, energy will be formed or produced. Second is the decomposition reaction, the reaction during which one reactant produced two or more products by consumption of energy in the form of heat, light or electricity. Okay, on the basis of types of energy used to decompose the substance, it can be classified into three types: thermolytic decomposition, electrolytic decomposition or photolytic decomposition. Thermo means heat. When heat is required to For decomposition, that process will be called thermolytic. When electricity is required, the process will be called electrolytic. And if light is required, that process will be called photolytic. Here are some examples of thermolytic decomposition. So first is FeSO4. When we will heat iron sulfate in a container, in a test tube, it will convert into iron oxide Fe2O3 plus SO2 plus SO3. Actually, FeSO4 is of green color, so very easily we can observe in the test tube only, and green color of FeSO4 will turns to brown color of Fe2O3. In the second one, calcium carbonate will convert into calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. When we will heat calcium carbonate, then it will convert into quicklime and carbon dioxide. Both the calcium carbonate and calcium oxides are of white color. Lead nitrate, the third equation is lead nitrate on heating converting into lead oxide plus NO2, nitrogen oxide and oxygen. Here I want to tell you the color of nitrogen oxide, that is of brown color. It is a gas and the color of this gas is brown color. So if we will heat lead nitrate, which is of white color, when we will heat it, brown color gas will comes out. This is second example or second type of decomposition, that is electrolytic decomposition. Electrolytic means we need electricity to decompose the substance. So when we will pass electricity from water, it will convert into hydrogen and oxygen. This is a type of setup. In a plastic mug, you can make holes at the bottom and fixed electrodes at the bottom, which are further fixed with a battery. And if we will switch on the battery, we can observe bubbles will start coming out from the electrodes. We can collect those bubbles in the test tube and check out. In one test tube, hydrogen gas will be produced, and in another test tube, oxygen gas will be there. So it means decomposition of water occurs. Photolytic decomposition, in which light is required. So one example, if we will place silver chloride in sunshine, it will convert into silver and chlorine gas. This is the color of silver chloride, white color powder in a china dish. If we will keep it in the sunlight, after some time, it will turns to this gray color. Silver chloride turns gray in sunlight, means it will change into silver. And chlorine gas will comes out. Silver chloride, there will be a chemical change if we will keep silver chloride in sunshine. Photolytic decomposition will occur and the color will be changed. So that's all about the combination and decomposition reactions. Next time we will go for the next type of reaction, and thank you for the day.